Okay, what we're going to be doing in this first section is finding extrema of functions. And the word extrema is just another word for the absolute max and the absolute minimum on the graph. So basically, we're just looking for the highest point on the graph and the lowest point in the graph. And when I ask you to find absolute max and min, I want the y value unless I specifically ask for the x value. So looking at this first graph, the highest point on this graph is right here. So absolute max is 6. Notice it is a cusp right there, so the derivative at that point does not exist. The absolute min is, this is the lowest point on the graph, the y value there is negative 3. We would also say this is an endpoint, so we're going to say the derivative there does not exist as well. Okay. Now, let's say I change this problem where both endpoints are open circles instead of closed. Then your max is still going to be 6. This is still the highest point on the graph. But when I ask you for the minimum, we're going to say there is no minimum because there's no point there. So really, the lowest point is going to be negative 2.999, etc. So we can't really define that point. So we say there is no absolute minimum. Okay, let's look at the next one. Same question. So absolute max, this is the highest point on the graph. So the y value is 6. Again, notice that this is another endpoint, so we say the derivative does not exist. The lowest point on this graph is negative 7. The derivative here, this is a smooth curve, is actually 0. And again, if I change this problem so your endpoints have holes, your max does not exist, or you could say none, because again, there's an open circle here. Your minimum is still negative 7. Okay. So the first thing you should notice is absolute maxes and mins can occur at endpoints. Now notice here we had a min here, we had a max here when it was a closed circle, or where the derivative does not exist because you have a cusp or a corner, or where the derivative is zero. So that's the first thing that you want to see, that maxes and mins, absolute maxes and mins only occur where the derivative is zero or does not exist.